You've heard it by now. Some posh wanker asked the Queen to suspend the Parliament in Westminster, and Liz, being the absolute mad lad she is, actually did it. Even Philip Hammond is calling Boris's proroguing a parliament undemocratic. The UK is on fire once again. Or rather, it continues to be on fire, but some Etonian has pissed petrol onto the flames. And Wales weeps. The expected nationalist responses have surfaced. Adam Price reiterated a call for an independent Wales, and many people are rightly pointing out this is exactly the sort of thing we would expect a disconnected English elite to do. Even Carwin Jones in his beautiful beard threatened that this could be the beginning of the end for the United Kingdom. Others in Welsh Labour, such as Pontypridd's Mick Antonyn, seem to be softening their position towards independence. And during all of this, Mark Drakeford has commissioned Alan Davis to lead a project to explore the future of the United Kingdom if we're to, as planned, leave the EU on the 31st of October. A bit late, but, you know, still welcome. At least we'll have something for the Welsh Government by October the 31st. Oh, no, it won't be published till Easter 2020, so I don't know what use that is. For those in the indie movement, it's a depressing but an exciting time. Welsh independence is being taken more seriously than ever, and it seems more possible, perhaps vital, than ever.
I think it's a brilliant idea, and Welsh independence is, right, having a rucksack and having your sandwiches in there, in your rucksack. So you can feed yourself, you can have your three meals a day.
But a huge question remains. What will independence look like? What is going to go in our sandwiches?
Oh, it's like hair in this.
Right now, the independence trifecta, Yes Cymru, all under one banner, and Plaid Cymru, seem to be trying to emulate the Scottish model. To keep agitating, keep marching for a referendum, win it, and then have a dominant nationalist party write the rules for a new state. It's a valid strategy, but have we probably spoken about if this is the way we want to go in the independence movement? The referendum avenue seems like a no-brainer, of course, unless someone wants to buy some tanks. But what about leaving the details up to someone else? I'm sure Plaid have lots of ideas for an independent Wales, but are we discussing what Wales could be enough within the movement? Institutions, the economy, democracy, etc. It's all very well to speak about Wales finding the courage to stand on its own in the world or whatever, but we need to consider what independence will mean for the everyday life of regular people. Arguably the biggest mistake at the EU referendum was that we went into it without knowing what a leave vote actually meant. Boris will tell you leave means leave, but that's only because ambiguity is in his favour, because he's now one of the top people in charge of shaping what our future relationship with the European Union will be. Him and his posh friends have a particular vision of Brexit.
You know who this is, as everybody knows?
So back to Welsh independence. Imagine a future situation where we win a referendum and the next day realise that we weren't all on the same page about what independence means. Some people might think we should be like Ireland and become a tax haven for Silicon Valley corporations, and house prices in Cardiff will soar to the ungodly levels of Dublin. The point is, right now, we don't know. The current trajectory of the independence movement means we are so fixated on becoming independent that we haven't really thought about what that would actually mean in too much detail. The experience of the Brexit referendum should cause us to think long and hard on this. When we get to that referendum, we need to have a really good idea about what we're voting on. It's not enough to say independence is the most important thing and we will work out the details later, because that is how we end up with a Wales dominated by the most powerful people. And if that's where we end up, then what's the point of independence if it doesn't change the material existence of the normal people at the bottom of society? That's a certain view of independence, sure, but hopefully one many people will be in favour of, and one that if we agree with it, we must fight for and advocate for. More strategically, can Plaid Cymru replicate the success of the SNP? Plaid got excited about a recent poll that put them ahead in the Senate projections, but the same poll put the Tories in front for Westminster seats. The SNP can spearhead independence because north of Hadrian's Wall, they're dominant. The same can't be said of Plaid in Wales. So if Plaid aren't strong enough to define what an independent Wales will be, then who is? Well, you are, and I am. we are. There's 3 million-ish of us in Wales, and we should be the ones deciding. The independence movement at this young stage is an opportunity for a broad, democratic conversation about where we want it to go. It's all well and good to be marching somewhere, but we need to discuss what we're going to do when we get there. We could take inspiration for how to do this from elsewhere. For example, in 2015, Barcelona elected Ada Colau as its mayor on a platform of policies not decided by her or by a small cadre of policy wonks, but by the people of Barcelona. Barcelona en Comú, a platform, not a party, organized assemblies in the neighborhoods of the city and let real people with real issues decide the direction of the politics of Barcelona. And those same people funded the project as well. It was theirs to own, not some rich donor or a bank. And in Rojava, in northeast Syria, a Kurdish-led, multi-ethnic, multi-religious coalition has built a form of local, municipalist democracy that attempts to emancipate all of its inhabitants. Not by giving them 3 or 4 chances to vote for a handful of representatives every decade, but by using assemblies within communities to order everyday life. These neighborhood assemblies federate at the town, the city, the regional, and the national level to form a democratic confederation almost unrecognizable compared to the centralized nation states we're used to seeing. These are just 2 examples of doing politics differently that Wales can learn from. There are over 50 similar municipalist projects worldwide on almost every continent. We could start building something like Barcelona or Rojava now, producing a platform where real people's voices can be heard and, more importantly, acted upon. Independence is a great idea, but what if my mum's calling me? Independence is a great idea, but what if we start acting independently sooner than that? What if we took Cardiff or Carnarvon, like the people of Barcelona, to control of their city? What if we expanded federations of social enterprises, like those of Cymru Bro Ffestiniog, to move towards a system of local control of businesses and resources, like in Rojava? We can invigorate local democracy and provide the framework for a renewed, independent Wales. Not because we like waving a flag with a dragon on it, but because we want to live somewhere where people get to have a say over their own lives. Independence should be the vehicle for a new politics, not just a project for its own sake. We need to start thinking radically and building alternative forms of politics right now. Because if we don't succeed, a new, independent Wales will look very similar to what we have now. Terrified politicians sitting in Cardiff Bay, doing their utmost to steady the boat so that benevolent, job-giving capitalists continue to invest. Establishment politics will not give this emancipation. We have to take it. We have to build it.